गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। टुडे वी आर आवर सेकंड लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर स्टडीड अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी। बट बिफोर दैट इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई सॉ यू अ पिक्चर एंड क्वेश्चन। दैट क्वेश्चन इज थिंक अबाउट द पिक्चर, इज दिस योर फ्यूचर? Are you think about that? Most of the student, they are think about that. And what picture tells? In this picture, a Wi-Fi modem is present at the center of table and each and every person having a tab or mobile phone with them. But what they do? They do a prayer to a Wi-Fi modem that modem gives us sufficient or good amount of network with which we play our mobile, we use our mobile. Student, can this is our need? No. Today, each and every student or each and every person having the different type of devices like mobile, and each and every mobile having the sufficient amount of network with them. But what they use about? The devices are used for using WhatsApp, Facebook, playing game, YouTube, and can you think it is necessary? It is need of our life? No, this is not need of our life. Our needs are nothing but the food, shelter, and clothes, and that only used by the plant. Hence, in last chapter, we see that plant physiology is the main source which fulfill our these three needs of food, clothes, and shelter. If you can't understand of misuse of mobile, then what will be the future of your children? We will see it in last slide. What is the future of your children? In this topic, we are cover, our main topic is introduction of plant physiology, part 2, and in this chapter, we only learn about the application of plant physiology. Here, plant physiology, it is a science or it is a part of botany which deals with study of various processes in plants' life, various physiological processes as well as metabolic processes in plants' life. The plants provide basic necessities of every life on this planet. They provide countless daily needs of animals' life, including man. Many countries from all over the world have problem of starvation and undernourishment due to the lack of proper knowledge of plant life. It thus needs heavy crop production and healthier plant life. This success can only be achieved by a proper understanding of plant physiology and control over the activities going in the plant. The researcher in the plant physiology have contributed to improve the plant life, harvesting of economic product, storage and preservation of yield, control over the plant diseases, various diseases and several other fields. And plant physiology, it is only branch which is the base of various branches of botany or chemistry that are nothing but the plant morphology, plant anatomy, plant chemistry, genetics, organic chemistry, plant biotechnology, systematics, cell biology, agriculture, botany and horticulture. All these branches, they having their base in plant physiology. Then what is the application of plant physiology? Here are the application of plant physiology. First one, importance of plant physiology in understanding basic of plant life. First point, plant physiology contributes in understanding plant structure and their exact role in plant metabolism. It is of great concern. It improves plant life. Basic knowledge of plant processes can help in increasing photosynthetic rate, conversion of solar energy for food production processes, and basic knowledge of nitrogen fixation, which is main element reducing agricultural production, and basic knowledge of creating protein deficiency all over the world. Due to the nitrogen, a specific deficiency are occurred in the plant and they reduces the rate of production in the plant. So we must know the application of nitrogen or use of nitrogen or effect of nitrogen. Further, plant physiology contribute in the knowing exact nutritional and water requirement. Each and every plant have the specific amount of water requirement. But in most of the cases, we give more amount of water to the plant, but it is unnecessary to the plant. In another way, the control of soil fertility, solving of problem of excessive salt in the soil is possible through knowledge of plant physiology. Here, in the plant physiology, we understand various metabolic processes or plant metabolism are studied, and how or how much amount of nitrogen is required for the plant, we must know, or we all have known that each and every agriculturist gives urea to their various crops. They require it or not, but farmer gives nutrient like urea. They does not check the soil. They directly gives every year a lot of urea. And what is present into the urea? In urea, there is presence of different nutrient, that is nothing but the nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. These are the main sources of the major nutrient. And can you imagine that how much of nitrogen every year farmer put into the soil? Huge amount of nitrogen is present into the soil. And if in some cases only a nitrogen requirement is very minimum until the farmer give it. Our next point is nothing but the importance of plant physiology in agricultural. Agriculture, India, it is a agricultural country. And our economy, or our total economy, it is totally based on the agriculture. And we must think about the agriculture and enhancement of the agriculture. But that enhancement is only done by the basic knowledge of plant physiology only. For that purpose, the researcher in plant physiology have been and are likely to contribute immensely in crop improvement, increasing in the crop productivity directly depend on the metabolic machineries of the plants, the production of new varieties and strains shall have to be taken into account the physiological attribute of the basic material in the genotype. The produces the various different new varieties. That varieties are helpful to the farmer to give more amount of production. Second one is knowledge of plant hormones. Each and every farmer must know about the knowledge of the farm hormones. If they knows about the knowledge of hormone, then and then only the agricultural land develop and they gives more amount of quality of the food material. Some growth regulator, they are nothing but the gibberellin, 2,4-D and they are used as a weedicide also when they use in specific concentration. It is well known and revolutionary fact at agricultural level to increase the crop production by application of these hormones, for example auxin and gibberellin. More of student, they are aware about the gibberellin because the gibberellin is mostly useful in the grape farm to enhance the quality of the fruit as well as to increase the foliage of the plant also. So these are the two main growth regulator, and that growth regulator are the hormones. The phenomenon of flowering and fruiting is regulated through the application of growth regulator, and at the appropriate time of plant height and age, these hormones are mostly used. The researcher in photoperiodism and vernalization. What is mean by photoperiodism? Each and every plant, they flowering at a specific period of time. Some plant, they are flowered in summer, some plant, they flowered in winter, and some plant, they flowered in day neutral condition. Then, such type of period required for flowering or growing, that period is known as the photoperiodism. Photon means light and periodism means period. That specific light period is required for the flowering or growth of the plant. Hence, that is known as the photoperiodism. And second one is the vernalization. Vernalization is nothing but the chilling treatment. Chilling means to reduce the temperature of the specific part of the plant or at the seed condition to reduce the temperature of the seed to enhance the growth of the seed. These are the two phenomena which are mostly useful to increase the female flower by higher yield in the cucumber, pumpkin and other plants. Next one is the photosynthesis nourishing entire living kingdom. What is meant by photosynthesis? A simple definition. Photosynthesis. Photon means light. Synthesis means to produce. What produce? With the help of light, plant produces the carbohydrate. And that carbohydrate is nothing but the important product, metabolic product, which give energy to each and every organism in the world. So photosynthesis is only process which produces the energy, and that energy comes from the sun. Sun is the source of energy, and that energy are converted into chemical form with the help of plants only by the photosynthesis process. And for that purpose, there are two types of plants, two or three types of, that are nothing but the C3 and C4 plant. C3 plants are these less efficient photosynthesizer than C4 plant. C3 plants are our basic food plant, like the pulses, oil seed crop, fiber crop, and staple food crop like the wheat, rice, and barley. Low efficiency of photosynthesis in C3 plant is due to the occurrence of photorespiration. Because in this C3 plant, the rate of photorespiration, it is also more, which derived the Rubisco enzyme from photosynthesis, and hence there is a need of sincere effort to reduce the wasteful product of photoperiodism, or to find out the new varieties of low rate of photorespiration. So worker are going on these different physiological laboratory work to increase the productivity of the plant. Next one is the stress physiology. Stress physiology, it is the emerging as a new plant physiology discipline. Economically useful plant that are capable of growing under the stress condition of dry land, low and high temperature condition, salt level with increased resistance to pest and diseases are developed. These are the various stresses, and if stresses are occurred, the productivity of plant is reduces. So agriculture is much known about the various stress of physiology. Next one is the understanding of water relation of the plant. We live in Saikheda, and in Saikheda that all area is known as the Godakat. That means that Godavari river, it is everywhere in all villages, most of the villages, and we not known about the requirement of water because we have huge amount of water. So we does not care of water. We use as we required. If plant need or plant not need, we give the water to the plant after every slot 10 to 8 to 10 days. We give plant a huge amount of water without thinking is this need of that plant or not. So we must study the understanding water relation of the plant. How much water required for plant per day or per week. We study that and then we give. In Israel, watering to the plant is given by the only drip irrigation system, and they calculated each and every drop of water and requirement of water to that specific plant, and that much amount of water is given to the plant only. And because they known about the value of the water, we have huge amount of water and we give more amount of water plant, then plant grows very well. Is this true? No. In some cases, when we give more amount of water to the plant, in that condition also some amount of productivity is lost in the plant because we give excess of water. So firstly, known which plant we are grow, what is the requirement of water per day or per week of that plant, that are study, and that much amount of water only given to the plant. That is nothing but the understanding of water relation of the plant. Next one is the seed dormancy phenomenon or problem. Seed dormancy problem, it is reduced by the plant physiology study. Studies in apple, peach, potatoes, etc. have shown that this plant require a winter or chilling period before their germination. What is my chilling period? Chilling period is nothing but the low temperature period after before their germination. By gibberellic acid treatment, this plant seed can be made to germinate soon after the harvesting. Ethylene chlorohydrins have also been found quite effective in breaking dormancy in some of freshly harvested potato tubers. Cytokinins are also most useful in breaking the dormancy in several plants. That means most of the growth regulators, they are useful to break the dormancy of various plants. Next one is the immature fruit fall in various fruit crop. We see that there is a immature fruit fall in a cereal. It is a serious problem in various fruit crop like the mango, like the apple, cotton, etc. And some growth regulator like the auxin treatment study have shown that successful immature fall of fruit in these plants, and enormous loss of this crop may be saved in this by using such type of growth regulator. The loss of cotton in about 60 to 70% due to the premature fall of cotton ball, but plant physiologists have noted that application of NAA can prevent this loss. And this is the various aspect which cannot be emphasized or which cannot be noted when we use agriculture or when we work on the agriculture. We must known about this factor, then and then only the productivity of our agricultural land they are increased. Next point, that is the importance of plant physiology in biotechnology. Biotechnology is an emerging branch in the science, not in the botany, but in the science, because this is the emerging branch because it having the biology, study of living thing, but with the help of some technology or technological aspect are introduced in the living aspect or living thing. That branch is nothing but the biotechnology. Here, enhancement of the various plant, they can be undertaken in this branch, in which first point is the hydroponics. What is mean by hydroponics? Do you know that? Most of the student know that, but some student they know that the hydroponics, that means the technique of solution culture, that soilless culture, they does not require the soil, they require or they means plant, that plant required some medium, and in that medium only plants can be grown. Here, that technique of growing plant in specific medium or culture, that process is known as the hydroponics, and that was developed in 1860, first in the Germany. The discovery of nutrient solution culture is the basis of all researcher on the plant material nutrition, and the formulation of nutrient solution culture is the basis of all researcher on the plant mineral nutrient and formulation of inorganic fertilizer for agriculture. Thus, hydroponics, it becomes the biotechnological byproduct. That means it is developed by the branch of botany, biotechnology. That means plant does not require the soil for growth. In small test tube, there is a medium, and in that medium, a small number of plants, small plant are grown. In a petri plate, the number of plant can be grown in that media. That is nothing but the hydroponics. Next one is the micropropagation. Micropropagation in a case of orchid, bananas, potatoes, etc. by correct ratio of the auxin, cytokinin, is a product of plant physiology, and this is boon to agriculture. It is a tissue culture, it is a part of micropropagation. Tissue culture also having the some specific media, that media is nothing but the Mauritius and Skug media. That media having some growth regulator, and that growth regulator enhance the growth of the plant or induces the growth of the plant. Some growth regulator induces the root system at the basal side, and some growth regulator enhances the shoot, and that process is known as the micropropagation. Micropropagation has been specially successful with ornamental plant, and many ornamental sold in the supermarket are thus propagated. They are somewhat costlier, and mostly in the supermarket they are available in the metropolitan city. Beside that, synthetic seed are also another part of biotechnology. Synthetic seed, they are developed by the plant physiology worker by tissue culture technique. Here, In the tissue culture technique, a somatic embryo is encapsulated by artificial endosperm and artificial seed coat formation, and the new plant can be grown in this technique. And last one, an important one, and most of the students know about the tissue culture technique, tissue or organ culture. Tissue culture or organ culture, it is now considered as chemical factory. Why? Because in a small place, a huge amount of plant can be grown. 100 plant grown in a 1 acre land, but in a 10 meter by 10 meter area, we can grow 100 or 1,000 seedling in very small place. And that is only undertaken with the help of tissue culture or organ culture techniques only. By tissue culture and recombinant DNA technology, transgenic plants have been developed and that need knowledge of the physiology. You understand that these all branches, they have their base in the plant physiology only. Without knowledge of plant physiology, none of these branches can be developed. Important factor is that the new emerging all branches like biotechnology, genetic engineering, tissue culture, then all another branches, they are their base in plant physiology. Next, importance of plant physiology in horticulture. Our country is horticultural country, agricultural and horticultural country. Various horticultural crop, they are grown in the India, and hence there is a huge importance of horticulture, and that horticulture is totally based on the plant physiology. The plant physiology study, they are importance in production of the ornamental, flowering plant, fruiting plant, vegetable, and in improving physiology of this crop so that economic and quality production are possible in this crop. When we see the world horticulture, the horticulture not only included the ornamental plant, but they also included the vegetable, the fruit, the different condiment plant. They are also included in the horticultural crop. Flowering plant also included in the horticulture. And in such cases, in vegetative propagation, these plants are grown with the help of vegetative propagation, and that vegetative propagation are nothing but the cutting, layering, budding, grafting, and the knowledge of the physiology is highly essential for all these vegetative practices. Foliar nutrition, it is required for growth of horticultural plant. After that, use of growth regulator. Use of growth regulator like the ethylene in artificial ripening of the fruit. Gibberellin is increasing the height of the plant, increasing the size of the fruit, and also increasing the carbohydrate content of the fruit. Improved cell division and flowering by the cytokinins, reducing water loss, and cracking of fruit by abscisic acid. These all are the growth regulator, and each and every growth regulator have the specific function. Gibberellin enhance the production of seedless grapes, improve flower and fruit quality in lemon, cherries, apple and pears. It is a product of plant physiology studies. Last point is the synchronization of flowering and fruiting. What is the synchronization? Synchronization of flowering and fruiting. Synchronization, that is nothing but the how much amount of flowering can be induces, and due to that how much amount of fruiting can be arises on that plant. That means how much amount of flowering, and on that flowering how much amount of fruiting can be undertaken on that plant. That synchronization is there, and synchronization of flowering and fruiting to achieve the good quality of fruit in horticulture crop can be affected by the use of growth regulator only. The regulated growth is described to avoid the sum of the environmental stresses also. When we know the various factor of plant physiology, we must studies about the stresses of physiology and to overcome all these stresses. They are studied here. Next one is the importance of plant physiology in forestry and plant pathology. Here, first point is the develop the fast growing tree. As we know, in forestry, the fast growing forest is required, because in last 10 to 20 years, the deforestation can be done by the various companies or various people for what? For industry purpose, for their for money purpose only. They deforest most of the thing, and most of the forest area they are undertaken into the urbanization area or urbanized area. So nowadays we must have the different fast growing trees. If you remember that before 10 to 15 year, the coconut tree, for growth of the coconut tree 10 to 15 years is required, but nowadays there are such type of new growing trees are there, they require only 3 to 5 year to their growth and they gives the fruits. And nowadays that is the requirement of future, that develop the fast growing trees. Next one is the improving the forest cover. What is mean by forest cover? Forest cover, it is nothing but the improving forest cover by fast growing plant species, that are vegetable cover with the increasing the plant and reducing the problem of pollution in our country, that are done with the help of improving the forest cover. More and more greenery are grown in the forest, and then only the pollution level is also decreases. As we see the COVID-19 corona situation from last 2 to 3 months, in whole world there is a lockdown, and it is a bad thing, but good. What is good thing in that? In this 3 to 4 months, the pollution throughout the world, that is reduced. That is the good thing. We realize that in these 3 months the pollution on the earth become reduces in huge amount. That is the done by the plant. Man, what can man done? Man can only sit in their home, and pollution are reduced by plants only, and the extra things which is done by the people, they are reduces, because the people are only in their homes and no wrong things are done by the people, and so the pollution of the world is reduces. And last point is the disease resistant plant, that is the requirement of the future. There are the different diseases are there, and we must produce the disease resistant varieties for improvement of the yield as well as growth of the plant. And that disease resistant variety can be प्रोड्यूस ओनली ड्यू टू द नॉलेज ऑफ प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी. दिस ऑल आर द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी. नेक्स्ट एंड इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट, दिस इज योअर चिल्ड्रंस फ्यूचर. वी सी इन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड एंड आस्क द क्वेश्चन, वॉट इज योअर चिल्ड्रंस फ्यूचर. एंड दिस स्लाइड शोज दैट दिस इज योअर चिल्ड्रंस फ्यूचर एंड दैट फ्यूचर इज दिस. चिल्ड्रन वॉन्ट टू प्ले बट यू आर मोर एडिक्ट आफ्टर 10 to 20 ईयर्स एडिक्ट फॉर मोबाइल. एवरी पीपल सी इन द मोबाइल बट द चिल्ड्रन वॉन्ट टू प्ले बट नो अ चाइल्ड और अ पर्सन इज फ्री टू प्ले विथ हिम एंड दैट इज द फ्यूचर. इफ यू नॉट यूज अ परफेक्ट यूज ऑफ मोबाइल और यू डोंट यूज द मोबाइल, दिस इज द मैसेज ऑफ टूडेज लेक्चर. इफ देर आर सम प्रॉब्लम देयर प्लीज आस्क आफ्टर द क्लास. देर इज अ कॉमेंट बॉक्स, इन दैट कॉमेंट बॉक्स आस्क क्वेश्चन. इफ देर आर सजेशन टू इम्प्रूव द लेक्चर देन सजेस्ट मी एंड आई कैन इम्प्रूव द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर मोर एंड मोर गुड. देर आर सम वोकैबुलरी प्रॉब्लम ड्यू टू द माइक और अदर थिंग्स और मोबाइल. नॉट various equipment are available with me, so these are only with the help of mobile I can make this video. So is there any suggestion, please send it on Google Class. In this way our first chapter is completed, and we after each chapter we conduct a small test. And that test are undertaken in our next lecture, that is nothing but the Saturday lecture. There is only a test. Each and every student, please solve that test, because in your assignment I also give the assignment about botany. Please see that assignment, and up to Sunday you write your thought on a page and click a photo and send a JPG image on the Google Classroom. For that you get a 10 mark test, that is. And Saturday test, a quiz, MCQ question is there, multi choice question is there only, that are solved and give a test. That record are on the Google Classroom. You see your mark on the Google Classroom only. So learn easily, learn all the thing about plant physiology. I are only mediator. You must learn yourself various things of plant physiology, and if there are some problem then ask me. Each and every subject are learned by you on the mobile, internet or other things. Okay, is there any problem? Please ask me. Thank you. Thank you very much.